Welcome back to EdTech School. Geography is one of the most interesting subjects to teach. Anybody can find a connection with this subject. Whether you are an Earth explorer, you want to become an astronaut, or you are just planning a city trip, geography is your best friend. Or at least it should be. Geography is about demography, sustainability, traveling, pictures. It's about field trips and the beauty of the Earth. There are some great resources available for creating interactive materials. Take this interactive mapmaker for example. Interactive mapmaker from National Geographic allows you to choose from a variety of base maps depending on the information you want to display on your map. If you want to see the climate zones on the world map and overlay this with another map, then you need to check it out. The True Size of Countries is another great website. We know that the Mercator projection introduces distortion. One of the downsides of the Mercator map is that it exaggerates the size of countries near to the poles, while downplaying the size of those near the equator. Tip 3 is the AuthaGraph World Map. AuthaGraph developed an original world map which represents all oceans and continents including Antarctica, which has been neglected in many existing maps, in substantially proper sizes. These fit in a rectangular frame without interruptions and overlaps. Visiting a city with your class is an exciting activity which engages the students, but the challenge is that when you send your students on the road, that they don't always have Wi-Fi available. With the BookWidgets app, all widgets can be preloaded on the iPad and you are still able to run without an internet connection. Basically, all widgets can be useful for a field trip, but I would recommend the quiz widget. In the quiz widget, you can use the info question type to give some extra information and assignments. Another question type that is particularly useful is a take or attach a photo question type. Students can use the iPad's built-in camera to take a picture and use this as an answer. Let them take a selfie with a certain statue or on a certain square. Fun guaranteed! An easy way to visualize differences between two pictures is the before and after widget. For instance, to compare photos of sceneries before and after the season change. You can also use flashcards, a classic self-study tool. This widget allows you to create flashcards containing text as well as pictures. The possibilities are endless. For instance, practice maps and landmarks. A video on geography without mentioning Google Maps? I don't think so. Create your own annotated maps using the Google Maps widget. All the features you've come to expect from Google Maps work, including street view and annotations. The hotspot image is one of my favorites. Present a single image with hotspots on it. Hotspots can contain text, images, videos, or a combination. Even small web pages can be in a pop-up. So, that was it for today. You can find all the links to the examples in the blog post, which is mentioned in the comments. See you next time!